Asime, come here. Come here. Mm-hmm.
Where were you? They said you were calling me.
Yes, I was calling you. Where did you sleep?
I slept in the dormitory.
You slept in the dormitory? How come you are not in your bed in the morning?
Eh?
Eh? How come you are not in your bed in the morning?
Eh?
Can't see me. How come you are not in your bed in the morning?
It was wet.
What happened to it?
Matron, I think we need AC in the dormitory.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, it can become very hot. And these days I have dreams when I'm in the kitchen. Then it gets very hot. Then when the sun is a lot. Mm. So yesterday I was sweating all over. Then it also rained.
Mm-hmm.
Then somehow the water came. Then it fell also on the mattress. We need what? We need help.
Help.
Like reconstruction of the dormitory. I hereby put it forward in administration that they change also the fashion of the roof and maybe put air conditioning.
Kasime, you know you sleep on the deck and you sleep on the lower bed. How come your friend who sleeps above you, the bed was not wet?
I'm very small, madam. They could have shifted me at night when I'm sleeping. They put me up for them, they sleep down. Like that, they switch like,
mm-hmm.
Yeah, they put me down, for them they go up.
Kasime, if you don't tell the truth, you know that I'm going to go and call your parents?
Don't call daddy. In the evening, when we were taking evening tea,
mm-hmm.
I took it to the dormitory, then somehow it was shaking, mm. Then it poured on the bed. Then when it poured on the bed, then I got my towel first, then tried to clean, then it put that brown map that you saw that was on the mattress.
So was it after the rain? Before the rain?
Which rain?
Kasim, I'm giving you 5 minutes to go.
Yes, so it had rained.
You 5 minutes to go get that mattress and take it outside. For sure, and you did urinate on the bed.
I'm going to be embarrassed.
Go and get a mattress. For sure, I know you urinated on the bed and you're here lying. Go and get the mattress.
Or just my mattress.
Kasime, go and take your mattress outside. You want me to call? Where's my phone?
We get our mattresses out. They're going to me get.
Kasime, I can still see you there. Go take your mattress.
Don't mess with Kasime.
Hi, Eva.
Hi, Anne.
Eva, what's that? What have you brought this time?
This is my office pillow.
Your office.
Yeah, you know what? I put it here on the chair. It helps me sit comfortably in the chair. Oh, and it's good for the back, by the way.
I know. You know, I can't stop smiling.
Why?
I am imagining how you stood in the mirror of your house at home and rehearsed how to convince me that pillow is for it to straighten your back. You must have said, office pillow. Office people. Who are you fooling?
No, you didn't understand.
You already have a blanket and you're always dozing 3/4 of the time in office.
Yeah, and
you've brought a pillow now. And because you've just thrown a name on it and called it the office pillow, no. It doesn't sound to be the pillow of the... Those are pillows of the bed. Remove that pillow and we see. That's a shame of the devil. Put it in the right and a shame of the devil.
This is just an office pillow for the chair, for the back.
You're just supporting... Are you a car that you need shock absorbers? That chair even swings over like this, and you need a pillow for it.
It's true.
You just want to sleep better.
Exaggerating.
Imagine if it's like a worker who works in a brewery coming in all the time with an opener. An opener, it's something that he has to carry. Wouldn't you suspect that they are drinking alcohol? Or if you are working at a bakery, and every time you come in, you have in some kazesta, some brew bandy, some jam, something for the bread. That is typical of someone who is eating products that are not supposed to be there.
You can't compare that to this.
Please, before we know it, you're going to come in here with a 6-inch mattress.
Hey.
Yes. And you say, it's my office mattress. And then before you know it, your man is in the office with you. People are busy climbing yourselves on those pencils and shelves and those files. And you're saying, no, she's just my office man.
No.
Just office man. You know how you doze off, Eva. It's not a secret. The other day I caught you on the computer. It was even on your hands, or even on the keyboard. You're like, if you can doze off when you sit like this, and you're bringing a pillow to just facilitate your sleeping.
Annie, you're really exaggerating, I swear. I don't like this.
This day is not going to be as bad as you think it is going to be, because I didn't intend to attack you. I just want you to know that I know what you are up to. I don't want you to think that I'm still here and I don't know what it is you are up
to. Can you imagine?
I know what you are up to. And as a matter of fact, I'm going to tell the HR.
No, you can't do this.
But you? I'm going to tell her. I'm not even going to tell her about
Akiru. Please.
I'm going to tell her, let them deduct lodge fees. At least they remove lodge fees off your salary.
Please, I beg you, you can't do
for
this
what?
To me.
For what? No, please. You're not. I'll be the one here who is suffering. I'll be the one who is doing all the work and your business sleeping. Sleep properly. You have a blanket there, pillow. I can even close and wake you up in case the boss passes around. Pillow, mbuko office pillow. Before you know it, you also have office makeup. You have office bed. You have an office bathroom. Once you have moved in here, you should actually be paying rent.
That is what I'm saying. That is what I told him.
Sebo, get off the phone, please. Get off the phone and stop that. Get off the phone. What are you doing? What is this? Do you think you're walking through a compost pit? What? This is someone's compound. This is someone's house. Please, or you think you are a photocopier that go around spitting papers, so you decide to spit leftovers of sugar cane. Please, have some respect. This is not your compound, eh? It's not your house.
I'm sorry, madam.
You're sorry? Why? So because you've eaten a sugar cane, if a sugar cane can make you frost like that in public and you go around feeling sweet, what if you are eating chicken? I think you'd now just be hitting us with bones and wearing the feathers in your ears. Eh? A sugar cane is making you behave like a wild animal. You're the people why we, you're the reason why we'll never develop in this place. So because you're eating sugar cane, you have to go around dropping the husks, eh? That is how it is supposed to be for you. That's how you see it. What if you are coming? Okay. Assuming you are a soldier coming for Afghanistan, how would we survive? You'd feel the need to go around distributing bullets, pa, 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 shooting anyone you want, dropping bombs and grenades as you will. Eh?
Oh, I'm sorry, madam.
No, please. You are an adult. Sorry should be coming from a child. Someone of your size. You look like you are tired already. You're the people feeding the world for nothing. Eating whatever it is. Where did you get that sugar cane? Did you get it from my compound? Because the chances of you having carried it from home are very slim. Eh? Please, let's be serious. Let us be serious. So what if you're coming from a romantic date? Mm-hmm. You'd go around dropping condoms for people to see. Simply because you're coming from a romantic date. Eh? What if you're leaving the toilet? What do you think you'd go around dropping as you are walking? Let's be serious. It's like, if you don't know how to eat these sugar canes, leave them for people who know how it is supposed to be disposed of. I am in my house. I have a dustbin. I can eat and put the husks here. As for you, give me just a second.
Let me pick.
Don't mess with Kasimi.
Started digging.
I know, yeah? I know, please.
Where did you plant this?
I even put seedlings.
You even
and,
have a
and
fence.
This soil is actually, yes, of course, I had to put a fence. You know, the Ranorang was in this village. I'm not going to be here suffering.
You have not yet finished payment. Yeah? What if those people change their minds?
Oh, why? Yeah? That's why I am putting plants. It's security. So that I tell them I've already started works.
Mm-mm.
Yeah.
Kasime, it's illegal. It is wrong to start planting things before paying.
Katamba. Stop using words in Nagarare. Carelessly. Anyhow, it's illegal. Where did you hear the word illegal? Am I planting marijuana here?
But
am I dealing in drugs?
It's wrong.
It's wrong how?
Eh?
It's wrong how? Hmm. So you want to tell me when someone gets a car on, they are not supposed to drive their car because they have not finished paying for it. No, that's what you're insinuating.
Just simply because, so I wait for what? I wait for them to first drum for me and I do a party and announce myself, oh, please, dear villagers, I am threatening to buy the whole of this land. That's why I'm tearing it. Is that what you're saying?
No.
Please, I do not have to first finish all the payment. Me, yeah. When I dig, I get money. And then I pay. That is the man I used to pay for the land. Part of it. So if I don't continue digging, I'll not finish paying for the whole land.
But
open your eyes, please. If you have nothing to do, continue do it somewhere else. But no, but what?
But you know, it's a problem.
It's a problem. It's a problem. That's what?
It has caused problems in this
how?
Village.
Who? How?
Mm.
You want to, let me ask you. You are the kind of women who refuse to give your husband's children because they have not finished paying dowry. As if they have closed the apparatus where the children would be coming from. No. Why don't you just give birth and let the man continue making the money so that they pay for you completely? You want to tell me if you have a loan, someone... So, you know, no, please. Because you have a loan, there's some money your husband has not paid, you're not going to give them children, eh? So you feel you know everything that is happening in this village? You are about... Hey, you just signed on the agreement. You're not even the one who sold the land to me, but you're now poking me. I'm not even working. I came here to work and plant crops, but I can hardly do it simply because of you.
Me?
Before I know it, you'll be telling rabbits at a... You rabbit, stop there. Do you have an eating permit for this garden? Huh? Do you know the owner of this garden? Do you know that this garden is under Rangos? You, squirrel, show me your national ID. You have nothing to do, Ria.
No,
because
have...
if you had something to do, you'd go and do it.
You, I have told you. Oh. I'm just telling you, you know problems here.
You know the examples you give are very stupid. You poke your nose in other people's business. Simply because you have not baptized the child does not mean you cannot breastfeed the child when you are the mother. So, but because I've not finished paying here, I cannot plant anything. When the land is already mine, so I let it be there. Just this is Africa, my friend. This is Africa. We always see incomplete church buildings. Does that mean that if worshippers go in that church and worship, the Holy Spirit will ignore them because they have not put tiles and concrete and roofing and the AC? Okay. Please, I suggest you let me actually do something. Me who has something to do.
Me have told you, Muna, problems here.
Problems here, let what? You're home. The one with you. Take away your gun. You are a huge feed. You're going to even end up stepping on my seedlings. You're already spoiling them. I have a hope you do not. So I dare whoever thinks that I don't have a right to dig here to camp. And I show them what I am made of. If you have nothing to do, find another place to... So you're going to tell the owner that I'm mining gold in their land. That's what you're going to say. That, and I think she's building. You're going to cause a ram for nothing. So before you mind your own business, before I make your dreams come true, and I refuse to finish the payment.
Don't mess with Kasime.